All right, let's ship some orders. We've got six totaling $156.
For starters, glad to get a large item out of here, clear some shelf space. This Milwaukee multi-bay charger. Took an offer, $45 for it. Remember when I said if you just touch something, it will sell? Well, I touched this twice the other day. Once when I accidentally knocked it off the shelf, and a second time when I was showing it to a friend who was over here. I had the opportunity to buy 40,000 of these. I'm glad I didn't because this is the first one that sold. Here's what it looks like. It is a Lucky Brand keychain. They are still sealed. I opened one to take pictures. I bought 10 of them. There's also bracelets right here. I bought 10 of them just as a sample to try them out. And had the opportunity to buy 40,000 of these at 10 cents each, so about $4,000. Glad I didn't because they just are not moving. Anyways, finally sold the first one, took an offer, $11. I did only pay 50 cents each, so that first one that sold for 11 pays for all of them because I've got $5 invested in all of them. The next sale, you know, I don't think I brought it out here yet. I was in the middle of listing stuff and then stopped. Let's go to my office. The next sale is in my pile of stuff that I'm in the middle of listing. Right here, paid $2 for this at a garage sale, and it just sold for $17. This one was a gamble, could not find any active or sold listings. I bought 2 boxes of these. They are sticker packs. It's 36 packs of stickers in each one, 4 stickers per pack. I sold this one, took an offer for $20. Sold another one of these, $27.99, if you remember. Got these on the Amazon pallets last summer. And lastly, I sold this Animal Crossing game. Still haven't taken better pictures of it, so I guess I don't need to now. I bought this garage ceiling last weekend for $5. It's got the original memory card. It's in excellent condition. I sold it for $34.99. I took pictures of this in my car because I was thinking it would be cool if it sold while I was still garage sailing. It didn't, but I never updated the pictures, so sold.
So a lot of people whine and complain about how eBay and PayPal only cares about the buyers and not us sellers and yada, 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 and jibber jabber, jibber jabber. I mentioned the other day I had a PayPal case opened against me over the weekend. Let me see if I can find an email. It was an unauthorized purchase. They must have done a chargeback or something. Wow, I've gotten a lot of emails here. So on Saturday, I got an email from PayPal. Please respond within 7 days regarding case number, and it has the case. It says, your action is required. You've received a payment that we believe may not have been authorized by the PayPal account holder. Here are the details of the transaction, and it gives me the details. It's $24.99 for a video game controller. They say, we recommend that you don't ship the item until our investigation is complete. Unfortunately, it had already shipped like a week earlier, which is weird. The transaction day was April 19th, and what was Sunday? Like the 20th, Saturday, the 27th. So apparently they assumed 8 days later I wouldn't have already shipped the item. Let's see, I lost my spot. So don't ship the item. If you've already shipped the item, log into the PayPal, go to the resolution center, provide shipping details, yada, yada, yada. They want me to log in. And so anyways, it was Saturday. I don't work on weekends except for the garage sales. On Sunday, I got an email saying from PayPal saying case opened. It says, we're writing to let you know that one of your buyers opened a case for the transaction. The buyer stated they did not authorize this purchase, and it's the same transaction and everything. And then this is where it's weird. Our records show tracking information is available for this tracking number. Oh, well, I guess I didn't read it right the first time. I read, if this is a digital goods transaction, please provide the download date. That's what I read and assumed that there was an error. But it does say records show tracking information and they'll review it as soon as possible. So I thought I needed to upload tracking. Well, the other day, probably Monday, I on video showed you the case and told you about it, saying that I can't even add tracking info or anything. It just says PayPal is reviewing it. So I did nothing. I thought about calling PayPal, but it's a $25 transaction on an item that I have nothing invested in. So all I'm really out is shipping if it does get refunded. So for the $4 in shipping, it's really not worth, even for $25, it's not worth me sitting on a hold with PayPal and dealing with all that hassle. So I was just going to let it go. Let them keep the item, keep the $25, and of course block them as a buyer. Well, last night I got an email from PayPal. It says, as you know, one of your buyers opened up a case with their financial institution. We're happy to confirm that this transaction was covered under seller protection and you met the seller protection requirements. The disputed amount is now in your PayPal balance. There's no further action required from you, yada, yada, yada. It doesn't say if they refunded the buyer or not, but I literally ignored it and did absolutely nothing. And I still got to keep my money. So they are in your corner. There might be issues where they side with the buyer more, but in general, I've found that PayPal and eBay is usually fair to sellers. That there have been issues, but don't let that deter you from selling on eBay if you're new and see all the people complaining and worried. Don't be worried. And if you are one of those people complaining, try to focus on the thousands of dollars that you actually do make rather than the tens of dollars that you lose. It makes it a little easier. So that's how that went. Shipped out all the other items. I think it was like 21. Let me pull this up. $21.80 for all the small items, and then the charger went FedEx for $20. Honestly, I think I probably ended up breaking even after all was said and done on that charger. Not a great purchase. I don't remember what I paid for it. It was a while ago. He's thinking about it. Making sure no one's looking. As soon as I drove off, he walked towards him and started eating him. I guess he was making sure I didn't want him first. What a considerate yard bird. So I just had to call the police. Driving down the interstate, I saw some road cones. Looks like they probably fell off a truck. They definitely weren't like from road work being done. They were in the middle of the lane, 70 miles per hour. I saw a semi truck run them over, and then they launched up from the back of the semi and hit another car. So they probably fell off a truck, called the non-emergency number so they can pick them up. Anyways, a lot of people in a lot of videos seem to be asking about my employees. They don't do any shipping. They don't do any sourcing or any listing. What do they do? And why don't I show them on my videos? Well, excuse me, my staff has absolutely nothing to do with the eBay side of the business. I actually run another business out of the warehouse. Remember, I make like $4,000 a month on eBay, $4,000 to $5,000 a month. That is not nearly enough to sustain spending $3,500 a month on a warehouse. Additionally, I do not need 7,000 square feet of space for eBay. That is way overkill. eBay is just a part of the business. Maybe one day I'll hire some people to do some eBay stuff. But right now, by myself, I spend maybe 10 hours a week on eBay, if that. So there's really no need to hire someone. It would be an extremely part-time person, but they would still have to be here every day to ship orders. It just wouldn't make sense. So that is why you never see my employees. They work on the brick and mortar side of the business. There were a couple more orders today. Now let me open my eBay app and get you a total here. Two more orders for a total of only $35, but I will show you those in a second.
So on my video, 10 hours thrifting in Milwaukee Goodwills, Ken Wilms says, if you get $30 for an obsolete microcassette recorder, I will eat my hat. Brand new Sony digital recorder sell new for $30.
Well, Ken, I have this old White Castle hat. It doesn't seem to be selling. I've had it in stock for a long time. I only paid 10 cents for it. So if you don't have a hat, you're welcome to borrow that one. Maybe get yourself a knife and fork. I don't know how good it's going to taste because the foam is kind of coming off. Probably why it's not selling. But you're welcome to eat that one instead of yours if you would prefer. Let me show you some stuff.
Now, unfortunately, in the last 90 days, I've only sold one microcassette recorder, and it was 20, so maybe you got me on a technicality. But if we look at eBay here, now we are in sold listings. Where is it? Right here, sold listings. These are actual sold. I just looked up microcassette recorder. There are 832 results. Now, I know you're going to go and say, well, maybe new they're worth more because they're vintage, so we're going to select used. Here, 613 results. By the way, I did go minimum of $30, so all 613 of those did sell for at least $30. So if you're wondering why, Ken,
the reason is because people who are afraid they're going to get hacked, you can't hack a tape. People who don't want something to be quickly copied, like psychiatrists, for example, they're going to want the cassette version because it's much more difficult to copy. And I guess old people doing old people things. That's the best guesses I have as to why those sell so well. But they do sell really well. I've sold them for as much as $100. In fact, the one that I sold, let me pull that up. What brand was it? Panasonic. It's a halfway decent brand. The Sonys do really well. You just don't find them that much anymore because, well, people know how valuable they are and they buy them up right away so they can list them. But they do sell. And if you would like to borrow a hat, you're more than welcome to. Or you could just wait until I actually sell one myself for $30. I do have that one from Milwaukee. So, yeah. Hope that answers your question in a very sarcastic way.
Let's start down here. Not that one. Not that one. Right here. Sold this scanner for $25. It does need a USB cable. So let's climb over here and grab a USB cable. And for $10, these fake dice. I actually got these in a storage unit about a year and a half ago. Listed them, and I must have accidentally done a 30-day listing, which expired, because when I was going through all this stuff, pulling anything that was not actively listed, I found these. So they ended up selling maybe a week, 2 weeks after listing.
So that's it for today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I decided I'm going to leave you with a big announcement. It seemed like too good to just let it go. So I decided to get back into Amazon recently. Yeah. See you later!